Feel as well. Stuck in the Middle on BBC Hereford and Worcester. Toni McDonald with you on a Saturday, and just the final weekend of the Worcester Fringe Festival, and what better way to see out the annual celebration of arts than with a good pop to the best rock and roll tunes, even better when they come from the king of rock and roll. So we'll talk. Come on and do the jailhouse rock, it'll be fancy shaking your thing to Jailhouse Rock, Hound Dog, Viva Las Vegas and more, then you can do just that with singer Sal Bashir and his award-winning show One Night With You, a tribute to Elvis. It's on at the Swan Studio tomorrow evening, and I asked Sal what's in store for people.
Well, they can expect a dignified, authentic tribute to the King of Rock and Roll, the Messiah of Rock and Roll, as I like to call him, Mr. Elvis Aaron Presley, who left the building over 45 years ago. My show is not an impersonation. I try to bring my own personality and charisma into the program. Where I concentrate more is on the voice, because before anybody saw Elvis, they heard Elvis. So by that very the line of thinking, I think it's important to put that at the top of the primary. That's for me. It's an entertaining show. We have fun. We have laughs. And there is a bit of banter with the audience as well, if we have time, because we're on a very strict time schedule for my show at the Worcester Theatre.
And it's an award-winning show. So which award did you win?
Well, I won the award at the Edinburgh Fringe Festival back in 2008, when I was seven. I'm only joking. it was a long time ago. So what, that's 15, 16 years ago coming up?
Bruno Mars started doing his own Elvis tribute when he was about four, I think, if you find that online.
Look at him now, and look at me now. He's done really well, but he's a huge Elvis fan. It was my very first Fringe Festival of any kind, and I did 30 shows in about 30 days in Edinburgh, and I was invited to the awards ceremony, and shock and horror, I won an award for the most outstanding performance in that the environment that I was in. It was called the Invasion Festival, so there was about 20 or 30 acts that took part from all parts of Asia, and I took part as well, so it was wonderful. It was a great moment for me, because it's got a lot of kudos and a lot of meaning for me, and I really enjoyed Scotland. I love Scotland. It was wonderful.
Do you do all eras of Elvis?
Yes, I'm quite a historian of Elvis, and a lot of my friends say I'm kind of a walking encyclopedia, but don't test me on anything. I've only just woken up about an hour ago after doing a show last night. Yes, I do the 50s, 60s and 70s, and Elvis's voice changed considerably in the 50s to the 60s to the 70s. So if you listen to things like That's Right Mama, it's very different from It's Now or Never in 1960. Mm-hmm. And it changed again around about 1968, when he did songs like If I Can Dream, which is a fantastic song. And again, when he got to the later stages of things like My Way and Moody Blue and songs like that. So his voice did change. There's a lot of singers that their voices haven't really changed over the passage of time. Cliff Richard, for example, his voice hasn't changed an awful lot. You can tell it's Cliff Richard, but if you heard Elvis sing That's Right Mama, you wouldn't believe it was the same person who sang American Trilogy, for example.
Do you know, I hadn't really thought about it. To be honest, I'm just thinking about it now. I think his voice probably got deeper and richer as he got older and was taking on those different styles, isn't it?
Well, Elvis was a singer. His pitch was amazing. When you have artists like Roy Orbison saying what a magnificent voice Elvis had, Tom Jones, they all tipped their hat to Elvis, because technically he was fantastic. He could sing anything. He could sing hillbilly, rockabilly, sillybilly. No, he could sing just about anything. And gospel, rhythm and blues, country and western, rock and roll. So much so that the listener was convinced that maybe he actually wrote the records, because he sang them with such emotion and such feeling that you could be convinced that he wrote those records. And it's amazing that Elvis's voice can change so much in different types of songs. I mean, Hound Dog is a very ferocious, aggressive song. It's an amazing, amazing track. And then when you listen to something like Crying in the Chapel, is that the same person? That shows the versatility and the range of the man's voice. The voice is everything, absolutely everything. The vibrato, what a beautiful vibrato. He even uses vibrato in rock and roll songs like Devil in Disguise, another song that a lot of tributes do. But when you look into technicalities of Devil in Disguise, it's amazing how he uses this urgency in his voice and the vibrato that sort of chugs along. And it's also used in Viva Las Vegas. But then the powerful songs of My Way, American Trilogy, and The Wonder of You demonstrate a completely different type of vibrato and different resonance in the man's voice. It's astounding. You, as an Elvis tribute artist and as a fan of music, and in particular the main man, numero uno, Elvis, it's a study. It's a study in music. And I'm never bored with any of these songs. The more I hear them, the more I learn.
Have you got a favourite era that you like to do in the show?
I wouldn't say I've got a favourite era, because I love all three eras, because they have magic and meaning in all three eras, eras that Elvis did. But I think vocally, I think Elvis's voice was at its absolute peak, where it could sing anything, probably from 1968 to 1971. There was a lot of urgency in Elvis's voice. He had a lot of raunchiness in there as well. And he still had that beautiful, beautiful vibrato and tone and emotion in his voice.
Yeah, and that's kind of like Suspicious Minds era, exactly. In the Ghetto, maybe that time of
Yes, life. Those songs were recorded at the American Sound Studios, which gave lots of hits to people like Aretha Franklin and people like that. And Elvis wanted to record in that environment. And thank heavens he did, because it brought Elvis back to the top of the charts in 1969, as you say, with Suspicious Minds, In the Ghetto, Kentucky Rain, and songs like that. Marvellous, beautiful songs.
How did you get into this song?
I was forced. No. I've always loved Elvis. My family grew up in the East End of London, born and brought up in Canning Town. Yes, indeed. And there was a pub opposite our house, and I used to play a lot of rock and roll music. And Elvis was played an awful lot. So I got my early influences by listening to Elvis from jukeboxes and stuff like that. And I just started singing from the age of 14, trying to sound like Elvis and pretending that I was him in front of the mirror. And of course, I looked nothing like Elvis. No one ever can. But I trained very, very hard by listening to the voice of Elvis and listening to other artists as well, like Roy Orbison, Dean Martin, and people like that. So I got into it in a very early age, and then I walked into a pub in 1997 and took part in a karaoke night for everybody. And I put my name down to sing Roy Orbison's Pretty Woman. So the karaoke guy said, well, ladies and gentlemen, we've got a young lady out there by the name of Sour. Come up, darling, give us a song. And of course, I stood up.
Yeah.
And there was giggles and sniggers and chuckles all over the place, which was fine. Mm. I got up and sang Pretty Woman, and everybody stopped drinking. And at that time, there was smoking in the pubs. It was allowed. And they stopped smoking, all turned around, and they gave me a standing ovation. And I was really, I felt something change inside me. I thought, this is really where I belong. This is what I need to do. And a few months later, I went to work for a couple doing karaoke and cabaret shows, working in all East End working men's clubs, pubs, a lot of spit and sawdust places, a lot of rough places, and I've got the scars and mental scars to prove it. But it was a great learning curve, learning ground. I served my apprenticeship, and I'm extremely thankful for that, because it has held me in good stead for the shows that came afterwards, with the ability to handle a crowd and generate some excitement.
Sal Bashir's show as part of the Worcester Fringe Festival is called One Night With You, a tribute to Elvis. It will be at the Swan Studio in the Swan Theatre tomorrow night, 7:45 p.m. Tickets at £12 or £10 concessions. Later on, you'll hear how his Elvis Presley show came about and which song he loves to perform.
We shared the guitars of Glastonbury.
With singer Sal Bashir and his award-winning show One Night With You, a tribute to Elvis, at the Swan Studio tomorrow evening. Now, Sal has been performing as Elvis for some years now, but I was interested to know what he was doing before the King of Rock and Roll became his life.
Before I started to do rock and roll and my tribute to rock and roll, and as you say, Elvis, I had many jobs in management, and my last employment, my last proper job, was with a train operating company at their head office in Blackfriars. I was their customer relations manager. So it's a huge change from dealing with signal failures and complaints and people who want to take you apart over the phone or in person if you was out on the frontline platforms. But it was a great job. I really enjoyed it. But at some point, I decided to pull away from that, invest my savings into the business, and develop my diary and go to speak with a lot of clients, and able to get a lot of venues and residencies. And it's 25 years now, full time.
And how many shows a year do you do?
I haven't really counted them up, but it's well over 100 or thereabouts. I do about 12, 14 shows a month, a mixture of charity, private shows and residencies. So it could be a wedding one minute, it could be a restaurant the next, then it could be a social club, it could be even, I've even taken part in some Fashion Week modelling for Gucci and Yves Saint Laurent, which I've done in the past as well. So, and then you get the odd TV interview and radio interviews, paper articles and stuff like that. So it's a real mixture. I'd like to say that I'm not strictly an Elvis tribute artist, although obviously I do perform a tribute to Elvis, but I also do a show called the Rock and Soul Show, which is a tribute to the 50s and 60s. And I just started up my own band as well, paying tribute to Buddy Holly, Beatles, Ricky Nelson, a lot of artists, and of course, the King.
And is it just the UK, or do you do them further afield as well?
I've performed abroad internationally. I've done places like Spain, Cyprus, Greece, and America. So I've done quite a few places. I'm not a great traveller. I'm not a great fan of flying, to be honest with you. But I think it's just waiting around at the airports for hours there and back. It sends my anxiety levels through the roof. Yeah. So I try and stick to the UK and travel all over the United Kingdom to do my shows. And to be honest, I'm so busy in the United Kingdom, I have very little time to go abroad. I haven't had a holiday since 1856.
You wouldn't know what to do with yourself. You'd have to find a bar to go singing, wouldn't you?
But if I do go abroad, I will try to relax if I possibly can. But knowing me, if I saw a microphone, I'm so there.
And who comes to the shows? What's the makeup of the audience these days?
Humans. I've had a few animals turn up every now and then. People who love music. I've had people who hate Elvis, who are under pressure to come to the shows because the rest of the family or their friends do love rock and roll, do love Elvis. And they've come away loving Elvis because of maybe the way I portrayed Elvis, the way I sang Elvis' song and the way I entertained and my visual performance. And of course, not trying to be like him as well. So I have a lot of people come to my shows, all ages, all colours and creeds, all come to my shows, and they leave happy. I always say, if you leave unhappy, I'll refund your money back.
And you haven't had to give out any money yet.
No refunds so far, but we have a great time. It's all about entertainment, and it's never to the detriment, and I must stress this, it's never to the detriment of Elvis's music or the rock and roll singers that I portray and pay tribute to, because they've paid for food in my fridge, they paid for my car, they paid for my house. Elvis has paid for the computer I'm looking at now. I'm ever so grateful to the industry that I'm in and the success, what success I've had, because it's given me a good living, and it's the best profession in the world. It's not even a job. It's wonderful to see people smile. It's wonderful to see people happy and go away from the shows where I've made a difference to the last couple of hours of being on stage.
And if there's one song you could pick that you love performing the most of Elvis's?
I think the most popular one, which is my go-to number, you've already mentioned it, it's Suspicious Minds. We can go on together with that song, thank heavens Elvis recorded it, because some shows where people are not necessarily there for you, for example, weddings are quite difficult to do, they're wonderful occasions, but people are not necessarily there for the singer. Then you might have a small group of people who will enjoy yourself, usually the person who's booked you. But when you put on Suspicious Minds or Return to Sender and Viva Las Vegas, they are up. They're up dancing. And then it makes all your stress levels go right down. And then you think, right, you know, we have now a go situation here.
Well, Sal, all the best with your show in Worcester. I'm sure people will be entertained. And
oh, yeah, I forgot to mention, it's the Worcester Theatres. It's the Worcester Theatre. They can go to all the W's there, www.worcestertheatres. I'm doing my show One Night With You. I haven't even plugged it. My good friend, my dear friend, Kevin Short, is going to be doing his own program called The Kevin Short Way. It's fun. He's such a great comedian. He's a musician. He's an actor. He's just come back from Adelaide. And he got me into this program with a friend. So thank you very much, Kevin. And he's responsible for the first one in 2008 in Edinburgh. So do catch his show and catch mine One Night With You. You'll have a great time. And as I say, it'll be on the 30th of July. So tickets are on sale now. So please, please buy some.
Sal Basir's show as part of the Worcester Fringe Festival is called One Night With You, a tribute to Elvis. It will be at the Swan Studio in the Swan Theatre tomorrow night, 7:45 p.m. Tickets are £12, £10 concession. You can catch his pal Kevin's performance of comedy, music and song, The Kevin Short Way, at 6 p.m. at the Swan Studio. Tickets for that are £10 or £8 concession. And book online for either show at worcestertheatres.co.uk or call the box office on 01905 611 427. That's 01905 611 427. Sal Basir, pleasure to speak to you. I hope the shows go well tomorrow.